Got a question here on the Facebook. Jason, how is your short-term memory and long-term memory now, and what have you found useful to retrain your lost memory?
Absolutely. Memory's been a huge thing. Short-term memory is shot, got none left. It can be the smallest thing. I mean, the greatest example I can give you is we're sitting down at an ice cream place down in the city just before, and I turned to Katie to ask for my jersey that was rolled up in her bag that was actually in there 2 days ago and not in there today. So, and I was completely convinced it was in there.
Yeah.
So just little things like that. In regards to what to do to recover that, I haven't done anything personally. I'm just sort of relying on the healing process to bring that back.
I mean, certainly that's what will happen, you know. I mean, over time that will happen. But the kinds of brain exercises that you described on that website really do hasten that process. So, I mean, just as if you break a bone.
Jason, you've got to get on and start doing that brain exercise.
Just as if you break a bone, part of the rehabilitation is rebuilding your muscles back up.
It's not all about walking and diet, pal.
Well, no. There is a really good, you've just reminded me, see my memory shot, Mike. No, there is a really good exercise on that website, and it's like a flashing light exercise, and it will sort of go bing once, and you have to click on it, and then it will go bing, bing, and then you have to, like, remember, it's a game of memory, if you know what I mean. So that's been really good.
What's the name of that one, David? There's a name for that one, isn't it?
Look, I'm not exactly sure what it is. There are a number of both tests and exercises that
sounds like you need some brain food, David.
Yeah,
I've got some omega-3 in my bag, man.
Have you been taking it?
Yes, no, I've been taking.
It's another thing that is really good for helping to.
Yeah, well, I don't eat seafood at all. Sorry, Mike. You're a Māori boy, but no, don't touch the seafood. So, I understand that you know, omega-3 was extremely important. So, pop 3 capsules a day.
Good on you.
And fingers crossed.
All right, we'll take a call. Raywin.
Hi. Can I talk to Jason?
Jason's right here.
Oh, I'm right here, Raywin. How are you?
Hi. Good. I'm probably going to sound like one of the lucky ones. In 1995, I had a brain tumour and a bone growth removed out of my head by Mr. Balakrishnan, Mr. Glassons, and Mr. Wellings.
Right.
One's a neurosurgeon, one's a eye surgeon, and one's a plastic surgeon.
I see.
And I had to have 11 small pieces of titanium metal put in my head, means I can't stand out in the sun with a sun hat on. And it means that I've got a forehead that fills up with liquid at a moment's notice, or a nose that bleeds at a moment's notice. But that's all I've got after that major surgery.
And you consider yourself lucky?
Yes, I feel very blessed. I was told I could eat up with epilepsy, but I didn't.
Oh, right. Well.
You're making me sitting here feeling I feel very small.
Oh, don't feel small.
After all the head surgery I've been through, and I suppose I was blessed that I missed that, but.
Oh, I tell you what, it's not a pleasant thing, but don't minimise what you've gone through either, have to say, like, as I was saying before.
I was very fortunate, Jason, they were both benign.
Oh, fantastic, that's blimmin' good news. Awesome, Raywin.
And I had a very good team.
Good.
I was in theatre all day and had a very good team.
Where were you operated on?
Wellington.
Wellington. How did you find the staff there?
Wonderful.
Good. No, so did I.
Absolutely wonderful.
Awesome.
Yeah, and I woke up with tubes and things coming out of all places, all holes.
It's a bit scary, hey?
Yeah, it is a bit.
Yeah.
It is a bit. And I had to be specialised for 4 or 5 days, but no, apart from that,
Oh, that's...
You know, I've got nose trouble. I've got a bleeding nose that bleeds at a moment's notice now, but that's basically that and my head full of metal.
Is the reason you can't stand out in the sun because it heats up too much?
Well, I've got metal just under my skin,
right,
my forehead.
Okay.
And I can get really bad headaches if that gets hot.
Yeah. My gosh.
But that's all.
Oh, that's all.
Can't they go in and replace it with plastic?
Sometimes I wish they could.
Hey, Raywin, thanks for your call.
Okay, you
thanks, Raywin.
You too. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
We go now to John.
Yeah, kia ora, James. Kia ora, Mike.
Kia ora, bro.
Kia ora.
Hey, mate. Hey, I was just driving back from Nelson through to Blenheim, and just a comment on, look, mate, I didn't end up with a brain hemorrhage, mate, but about this time last year, or quite possibly around about the same time as you, went to hospital for what I thought was just a routine checkup, and woke up a few weeks later out of a coma, mate. So I just wanted to comment on it, just to say that I know exactly what it's like for things to happen totally out of the blue.
Yeah, man. What was the story there? What did they say had happened?
Oh, thing called diverticulitis, mate. Basically, it was just I believe it was a cyst on the side of my bowel, and that just exploded and just sent poison right through me. So, look, I just wanted to ring. I'm working tonight, mate, heading from Nelson back to Benham. I just wanted to say good on you, bro. Never give up, and just kia kaha to everyone else out there, I say.
Cheers, bro. Hey, thank you so much for that, bro.
No hey. Worries. Hey, and Mike, you got a good show, my man. You keep that up, hey, bro.
Thank you, brother.
All the best, eh?
Ka kite. Matewa. So, any final pieces of wisdom for people out there that are going through maybe some traumatic times in their life? You know, I mean, not many people get to face up to a life and death situation, especially one so young.
Mm-hmm.
It has matured you, hasn't it?
Oh, I believe so, mate. Yep. No, I think I've got another perspective on life. And we'll continue to use it in a positive way. I hope I can just keep passing on that message to everyone that life does go on and things do happen for a reason, and just, you know, break it down and figure out why it did happen. Yeah, yep.
What are the important things in your life now?
Important things in my life? To be alive. my family have become a lot more important to me. There was a time of quite distance between us. Through the surgery, I have to say, like, just because there was that fear that I was going to die, so I was sort of consciously pushing them away.
Disconnecting.
Yeah, man. So, I mean, that would be a huge message for everyone too. You know, if you are going through any sort of surgery, anything to do with the brain, just don't disconnect yourself from your family. There's definitely times that you want to just shut yourself away and you know, bury your head in your pillow, but it's not going to do you any good. Just, always pick up the phone and give someone a call if you need to, because... friends are out there to help you get through everything, and it's the most important thing. Yeah.
Fantastic, Jace. Absolutely brilliant story.
Yeah, man.
And you're a very, very lucky young man.
Tell me about it, mate. No, very thankful. Thanks for having me on.
No, you're more than welcome. Any last words, David? It's very unusual for you to be here this late, David.
It is indeed.
Yeah.
Feeling a little bit... but. Dopey on it.
Oh, look, I mean, harden up, mate.
Now, why am I not surprised that you say that? I'd just like to kind of echo Jason's first words, which are really about the strength and value of relationships and social connection, really. And, I mean, that's not only about feeling better, but it's actually about being healthier. It's about health and well-being, is having connections with people. And so, yeah, that's my take on this.
Good take.
Thanks, Jace.
Thank you.
Great having you along. David, catch you next week. Cameraman, thank you, linesman. Thank you, ball boys. Good night from you guys. I'll be here till 12. 0800 723 465 is our number. Catch you after the news.